time.
Four.
Nerdgasm.
Hey, what's up, guys? Jerry here, a.k.a. Barnacles, and today I'm going to show you how to use your computer to save mankind. Okay, that might be taking it a little bit too far, but it's honestly not as far from the truth as you would think. Basically, Stanford University came up with a program called Folding at Home. Now, it's been around for a long time, but still tons of people don't know about it. It's a little program that runs in the background of your computer that utilizes the idle cycles from your CPUs and your GPUs to simulate something called protein folding. Don't worry, it's not going to use cycles on your computer when you're doing stuff like playing video games and watching porn and watching Netflix and watching porn. So you don't got to worry about that, guys. You don't got to worry. You can configure it at several different levels where you almost don't even know it's on the system, all the way up to, holy crap, why is my mouse cursor not moving? But what this program does is simulates this protein folding. And basically, in a nutshell, proteins inside of your body do jobs. They go around and do all kinds of stuff. I don't really know. I'm not a biology major. I mean, they do stuff. But in a nutshell, every once in a while, these proteins arrange themselves in a bad pattern. And when they arrange themselves in that bad pattern, they start doing the wrong job. And that's where you get diseases like Alzheimer's, AIDS, cancers, Parkinson's, Huntington's, mad cow disease, being an asshole. Okay, maybe not the last one. But the problem is, science doesn't understand how these proteins fold into these patterns incorrectly. They're like, why the hell does this protein just not do the same thing like it's supposed to every single time? Why the hell does the protein got to be a dick and start like doing the wrong thing? Well, because they don't know that, they need data to figure it out. And this protein folding software called Folding at Home runs on your computer and basically simulates all the different permutations and possibilities of these proteins folding into things and stuff. And man, I really don't understand how this works, but I mean, Stanford, right? It's Stanford, guys. Stanford's not gonna lead us wrong. Watch, they're probably like Bitcoin mining on our computers and just showing us a protein. I'm pretty sure that's not what's going on here though, guys. But in all seriousness, recently I took my computer into Puget Systems and had it upgraded with 2 Pascal Titan X graphics cards, which are some of the fastest, if not the fastest GPUs in the world. Now, when I went to sleep that night, I kind of felt like a dick because I was like, my computer's sitting up there with all of this power and performance and it's not going to good use. It's just sitting up there in the computer and doing nothing, you know? That was sad. But then my friend Adam messaged me and said that he was doing Folding at Home again. And I was like, oh, I remember Folding at Home. I did that on my PlayStation 3 like 57 years ago. And then I realized that the Titan X GPU pulls amazing scores. Like, it folds like none other. I mean, it folds better than most maids. So I downloaded the software, and with help from my friend Kevlar Condom, I got it all set up and running, and my computer instantly transformed into a space heater. Okay, I'm not gonna lie to you guys. If you choose to go down this path and run this software, it is gonna run your computer hard. Now, your CPUs are designed to run at 100%, your GPUs are designed to run at 100%, so it's not gonna hurt your hardware, but it is gonna run your power bill up slightly, and it is gonna superheat your room. So unless you have an air conditioner like me in the window or something to keep the heat regulated in the room, I might recommend you don't do this. But if you are like me and you have an AC in the room and you have an ultra powerful computer and you wanna join the Barnacles Nerdgasm folding team, I'm gonna show you guys how to right now. Just navigate to folding.stanford.edu and your favorite web browser, and you can watch their little video on how the program works, or you can just scroll down and read some of this information. The statistics are a little dated. There's a lot more than 85,000 computers participating right now in the project, and it's easy to tell because you can come down here to the bottom and click the download button, and you immediately see it says add your computing power to over 327,000 others. So, and who even knows how the statistic is, but steer, I would expect this to be in like the tens or twenties of millions. Think of how many computers out there are literally doing nothing while people are sleeping. And even if they are doing something, you can still contribute idle cycles. The only time that you really want the program to go idle is when you're doing like CPU intensive operations and GPU intensive operations. Otherwise, this thing will figure out how to utilize that power while you're even on the computer. Now, you can also download a client for your Android phone. Now, I don't think your Android phone's gonna fold very fast, but if a billion Android devices get on the network doing this, obviously that's gonna add up, and that's the beauty of cloud computing. So go ahead and click on that download button, and you're gonna get the FAH installer downloading here, which is about 30 megabytes. All right, so once you have the client downloaded, you're just gonna run the EXE, and it's gonna open up with the Folding at Home client setup. You're just gonna click the next button. They got some information in here you can read. I don't think anybody actually reads end user license agreements. I'm sure it's nothing like Microsoft where they say they're gonna capture every single keystroke you type into search and send it up to their back end. Yeah, not bitter about that. Okay, so once you agree to those terms, go ahead and just do an express installation. You can also do a custom installation if you want to like pick and choose which components you want to install, or if you don't want the screensaver installed. Now, I had already installed it previously, so you can see it's removing the old version, it's reinstalling the new version because I want to walk you guys through the setup of this thing. All right, once it's done, it's already going to start folding at home. Just click finish. Now it's going to open up your web browser, and the web browser is going to connect to the service on your computer. They basically use this as one of the UIs. Now you can see from this page, I am supporting cancer is my primary research. And then on my laptop, I also support the Alzheimer's because my wife's father is currently suffering from that. And it's a terrible thing to watch. So I would love to see cures for all of these diseases, but those are the two that hit closest to home for me. All right, you can see right now I am folding as Barnacles on team 231300. That is the Barnacles Nerdgasm team. And that will be important if you want to join my team and get recognized in the future for the work we're doing. Now, currently, my beast of a system has earned 2.35 million points, and the Barnacles Nerdgasm team has a total of 6.8 million, and that's combined with everybody that's already joined my team. Now, if you open up the Barnacles Nerdgasm team stats, you can already see that Kevlar Condom and I are in first place. That's because we both have Twin Titans in our computers and Dual Xeon, so our computers are doing some serious heavy lifting. You see, Kevlar Condom's gaining on me fast. He'll probably actually surpass me at some point. And then you can see we've already been joined by, wow, we're up to 108 people. And I'm hoping after this video launches that this literally gets into the tens or hundreds of thousands, guys. So please share this video. If you guys support the cause, please share this video. And also, even if you can't run it because you can't afford the extra electricity or you don't have the cooling in place to support your computer running full tilt 24/7, then please spread the message to others and other people might be able to do it. And just by you sharing that message, you are having a huge impact. So right now, my team is ranked 2,391 out of 224,904 teams. So you can tell there are a lot of computers doing work, but we're climbing the ranks quick. And if we get up into like the top 10 with this, I'm going to do a follow-up video and I'm going to call out some of you guys, maybe the top 10 people that had the most work units processed. Now, my client was already configured from the previous install, but when you install this, you're going to see a dialog pop up and it's going to ask you whether you want to be anonymous or whether you want to have an identity. Go ahead and select that you want to have an identity. Then what you're going to want to do is put in your name or whatever identity you want. And then it's going to say, do you want to join a team? And when it in that box, make sure you type 231300 to join the Barnacles Nerdgasm folding team. If you don't enter that number, you will just be folding on your own and you won't be a member of the Barnacles Nerdgasm team. Now, for some reason you guys hate my guts and don't want to be a member of the Barnacles Nerdgasm team, I urge you to create your own team and invite your friends to that team. I honestly would love to see the Barnacles Nerdgasm team get huge, but I am more interested in the research that's being done behind this, and whatever compels you to do that is going to be what you need to do, because in the end, if you can help with this, that would be awesome. You guys know I do a lot of stuff with cancer research. I do stuff with Seattle Children's Hospital. I do something with Movember every single year. I am a huge, huge proponent of cancer research. And this just makes sense to use your idle cycles towards something good. Now, if you look at the user interface here, down here, it has the power. You can do light, medium, or full. When you're on full, it's using all of your GPU power and all of your CPU power. All right, you can see now when I pull in Task Manager, and keep in mind the computer is still very responsive, you can see all of my CPUs are maxed out. It's using 100% of the power. And you can also see over here that the GPUs are also being heavily utilized. Now, if you back it down to medium, then you can use the computer and you don't even realize anything's going on in the background, but they're still trying to do a balance where they're using cycles even when you're using your computer and cycles that they believe that you're not using. But if you're playing games, live streaming and doing stuff like that, drop it down to light. And if you drop it down to light, if it detects you're using the computer, it's gonna back way, way off. Now, I turned it to light for the purpose of shooting this video because I'm using OBS Studio to capture everything today. But when I walk away from my computer, I go ahead and just pump it up to full. And when I'm sleeping at night, it's on full, and this gives you the maximum contribution to science. Also, when you install the client, you're going to get a little thing down in your task tray here, the little folding active pane, where you can quickly change between full, medium, light, so you don't have to open the web browser. You can also select on idle, which is a mode that's not offered through the web page, which basically means it will only do work when the system is 100% idle and you're doing nothing. The second you move the mouse, touch the keyboard, or do anything, it's going to go ahead and kick that off. Now, you also can go to the web control, which is the page you just saw previously, or you can go to the advanced control. Now, the advanced control UI gives you a lot of information about like what CPUs and GPUs are running, what work queue they're processing, how long it's going to take for each one, and also gives you the links to the projects that are currently underway. So you get a lot more in-depth information through this console and like what's going on with the computer and the threads, and you even get like full logging on what's going on between your computer and the servers and everything. So if you like to keep a close eye on things and you're a power user, I'd highly recommend this. You also have the slider, just like in the other UIs, to control what is going on, but you can also click this button over here in the corner that says Viewer. Now, when you click the Viewer, you get a UI that pops up that actually shows you in real time the protein folding occurring. You see, wow, this is a huge protein. Usually they're a lot smaller than this, but you can see this whole thing folding and being manipulated, and this is generating all of the data and running those live simulations, and that data is gonna be sent back to Stanford. It's awesome. You can also configure a screensaver if you want on your computer, so that whenever your computer is idle and the screensaver comes on, it starts automatically running in the background, and then the screensaver shows the protein as the screensaver, which is really, really cool. Now, I also noticed when I clicked on the Advanced tab that you have the cause preference, and it says if you prefer to select a particular cause, you can do it here, but it says this does not guarantee that all your computing resources will go towards that specific cause, but I do suspect that they're going to try to as often as possible to make sure your CPU cycles are going towards that cause. But if there's another cause that's more important at the time, or they're making more progress with, I'm sure they're going to move that around at their convenience. Now, also, the folding core priority is set to lowest. This prevents your computer from ever hanging or stuttering, even when it's going at 100%. But you can also set it to slightly higher, which will even use more CPU, but it could cause some problems with your computer and its responsiveness. So again, it depends on what you want to do. But I really like the web UI. The web UI is very, very clean and easy to open and just tells you everything that's going on. It's also cool to click on the See Stats button right here, and you can actually see your lifetime stats, everything that you're doing, and you can share that with your friends on Facebook and social media and Twitter and Instagram and everything like that, because it's cool. It's kind of like a game. You're trying to see if you can get a high score and how fast you can climb the ranks. And while you're doing this, you're also burning in your computer and verifying that your computer is stable. If you experience hangs and lockups while running this test, it means that your GPU and CPU are not at a stable overclock and you should back them off. Now, guys, I'm not an expert in biology, like I said, but we can trust this because it came from Stanford University, and the Folding at Home project has been around and vetted for a very, very long time. This is not a new thing. If you haven't heard of this, it's because they're just having a hard time getting the word out, and I'm trying to do my part to get it out more, because you guys know that I stand behind cancer research huge. I lost my mom to cancer. I lost my grandpa to cancer. My wife's father, my father-in-law, he has Alzheimer's. And it's just, oh God, it sucks watching this, and it feels so good to feel like I'm doing something. And you never know, your computer might be the one that folds the protein in the package that leads to the fully understanding of the mutation in the first place and leads to the cure. Again, I would like to reiterate that I'm not compensated in any way for doing this video. I'm doing this video because I firmly believe in this cause, and it's something that I started doing now that I have a computer that can do an amazing amount of processing work, and I have an air conditioner in my window that's 12,000 BTUs that can literally handle both of those Titans, both those Xeons running at full tilt 24/7. Now, depending on the performance of your computer, the heat is going to vary. If you have a computer that's lower powered and you contribute to the project, you might not have any of the heating problems that I talked about previously. Just make sure that your room and your environment can handle the heat of the full load of your computer running all the time. I also have my laptop over here from Puget Systems folding at the same time, and it has a 6700K Intel desktop processor in it, and it's blowing heat out the back like crazy, but I've been running it for 24 hours continuous without a single hiccup, and the system is working beautifully. So guys, I really hope that you take a moment to install the Folding at Home software, and I really, really hope that you join my team, because I would love to see the Barnacles Nerdgasm teams have tens, even 100,000 computers contributing to this project. And what I will do is try to get everybody recognition in future videos when I talk about this further, because I think it is a great cause, guys. You should think it's a great cause too. A lot of people will argue that this is an inefficient way to do the research, because obviously this program isn't the most well optimized thing in the world for protein folding. You can create things like ASICs and things like that for Bitcoin, like Bitcoin mining uses, to be more efficient at doing it. But the problem with that is it costs Stanford a lot of money. It takes a lot of HVAC, a lot of electricity, and a lot of resources. And when they use cloud computing to spread it out over the earth, the combined power of a million desktop computers is going to beat anything that they're going to be able to build and operate in the data center. So guys, join up. Let me know down in the comments if you guys are folding, and please go ahead and give me your identity down in the comments so that I can go in and line it up when I'm going through and watching our team grow. And I also have a link in the video description to the team so you yourself can see all of the members of the team in there, including yourself, once you process your first work unit. This is going to be awesome, guys. I absolutely love this. Also, this whole video was shot with a Logitech C920 webcam, my A2020 microphone, using OBS Studio in a live streaming configuration at a slightly higher bitrate. Not all my future videos are going to be shot like this, but I thought that this would be a really great way for me to interact seamlessly with the screen and back and forth with you guys. So let me know if you also like this format down in the comments. If you guys enjoyed this video, I would really appreciate that you slap a like on it. If you guys haven't checked out some of my other content and this is the first video you've ever seen that I made, trust me, I've got some cool stuff out there that you're gonna like. I might even have some stuff that you're not gonna like. Hopefully you land on the stuff that you like. But at any rate, if you enjoy what I do, please subscribe, please support the channel, and until next time. Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed this video. Please take a moment and subscribe to my channel. It helps me a lot. Also, come over to Twitter. I'm at Barnacles. I'm a real social guy. Also, if you have a couple of minutes, check out some of these many other videos. I made them myself.